sell the finest quarter horse in the whole Southwest.
At half its value.
Oh, I've been taken, huh?
Well, you just don't know the market, boy. I know hard feelings, but somebody's always got to get the best of the deal.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You'll know who, too. That rat-maned, black-hearted fence-buster joins the crowd in the grandstand the first time you try to race him.
Big game going on upstairs.
Game?
Poker.
Oh, no, sir. Thank you, but thank you, no. Well, I play cards. There's mastics, jelly beans, licorice whips, but never for money. No, sir. I'm a loser, mister. When it comes to cards, I am a loser. But now, horses and women. Well, that's something else entirely. Dog, we're fat with a fallen money. It's time we were spreading it around a bit. Well, wake up, dog. Ladies, care to join me in a cooling glass? Miss Two?
Back to the miners, Busher.
They live around here?
Right here. Why?
What room?
I'm sorry, but the employer's just establishment. They ain't allowed to give out that information. Room 601. 10 more and I'll open the door. I know him.
So what?
I know his money.
Look, Deirdre. Orphan Annie. Well, sit in or walk out, Buster.
Walk out, honey. You got the wrong pad. This game's table stakes.
Me $30 worth. Another $470.
Yes, Mr. Blassingill.
Dave Blassingill.
Gentlemen, the name of the game is five-card draw, guts to open. Is that all right with you, Mr.
Either I get that $187 you owe me right now, or I'm going to take it out of your hands.
Gentlemen, allow me to introduce Mr. David No Middle Initial Blassingame. Mr. Blassingame is famed as an entrepreneur in the pricing, sale, and theft of fine horse flesh, which, unfortunately, have a penchant for running out of the money. David, allow me to introduce Mr. Farr, Mr. Mullaney, Mr. Monroe, and Mr. Anston. Well, gentlemen, I think some word of greeting is appropriate for a man who once saved me from a fate worse than death.
I have a word, Mr. Smith. Deal.
Ace bets.
$50.
Hold.
I'll call.
Ace queen.
$100.
I fall.
Loose call.
Pair of aces.
300, 400, $500.
I feel the soft, caressing hand of Dame Fortune. Call.
Pair of tens. Two pair.
$1,000.
Mr. Anson, how much money do you have in front of you?
$1,200.
That's my raise.
Call.
Poker, gentlemen, is reputedly a pastime of permutation and combination. In truth, it's like a woman's love. In other words, you never know what's going to happen next. 30 miles of railroad.
A winner. That's poker for today, boys. You got the guts of a stud bull, Mr. Smith.
I must admit that you're a barrel-jumping, poker-playing, double-dealing, suicidal maniac.
I'm truly regretful of your financial predicament. However, I'm a man who is liberal with his largesse, so we'll have a little celebration, a bacchanal, so to say.
Party?
I don't stint, do I, Dave?
You, still in the oil business?
Oh, sold out about a year ago. Took a flyer in fertilizer. Got cleaned out by a Sunday school teacher from Pecos.
You cleaned, huh?
To the bone. But with this state, we can start again, David, and I've got plans, and I don't mean poker.
Horses?
Emeralds. A river full of them.
No, thank you.
South America, David. Beautiful, soft-eyed maidens waiting in the moonlight.
No, I got an option on 600 acres up near Deming. I think I'll pick up on it. If I can get the money that's owed me.
60-40.
That's a deal.
Yeah. Yes, that's right.
That's right, darling. Soothe the sacrum, honey. Oh, yes, lubricate the lumbar.
Boy, Smith, you know that last bet you threw at Aston?
That sure was a beaut.
I always come equipped, David. You can't play poker like it was a game of chance. A guy could lose money that way.
Hey, Smith.
Huh?
One of his cards is missing.
Are you sure?
He's sure. Anson took a card with him. He always does when he loses. And then he has it checked to see if anyone snuck in a pack of readers.
Wait a minute. What are we running for? If he was suspicious of us, he wouldn't leave us alone, would he?
Come on.
Hey, Smith. We ain't alone.
And Jane walking out, are you, honey? We're supposed to keep you until he gives the okay. And we've never missed yet.
I'm dead. I want him maimed. But, sir, I had nothing to do with that. Why, Smith, you low-down, rotten card sharp. Give the man his money back.
I beg your pardon, sir. Pardon me. David, how dare you? Are you trying to intimate that I would stoop so low as to cheat at cards?
Smith, I warn you.